additional significance and likelihood of impact from groundwater withdrawals. MFLs are required and defined by Florida statutes as the limit at which further withdrawals would be significantly harmful to the water resources or ecology of the area. These are the different water resource values that are assessed during the MFL process. At the time the MFL is developed, the status of the MFL is assessed based on current water use and projected future demand. If an MFL is not being met, a recovery strategy is developed. The water supply plan evaluates the potential influence of current and future pumping on established MFLs. In some cases, the status of a water body may change as updates are made based on new water use projections. When determining the status of an MFL, there are three different areas assessed. If the MFL is not being met, a recovery strategy is needed. If the MFL is met under the current pumping scenario, but is expected to fall below the MFL during the 20-year planning horizon, a prevention strategy is needed. If the MFL is met under current pumping and is expected to be met over the projection period, no recovery or prevention strategy is needed. We will discuss the methods used for water bodies with established MFLs on the next slide. In addition, there is active work underway in the planning area to establish new MFLs and update existing MFLs. This work will be done in parallel with the planning process, and we will provide details at the end of this presentation on how to engage with these activities. In the planning region, there are two areas that are covered by adopted recovery strategies, which are the Brooklyn and Geneva Recovery Strategy and the Lower Santa Fe and Okotoki Recovery Strategy. These strategies will be appended to the updated water supply plan and include actions to be taken to recover minimum flows or levels. For this plan, the status of MFL water bodies associated with an adopted recovery strategy are incorporated from the strategy. The need for additional projects will be examined based on the projected growth in the plan. For other MFL water bodies, flows or levels were extracted from the NEFSEG model runs for pumps off, current pumping, and the 2045 projection. For the Suwannee River Water Management District, the percent change was calculated from pumps off to current pumping and pumps off to the 2045 projection. These percentages were then compared to the reference criteria of the water body to determine current and future status. For the St. John's River Water Management District, lake MFL status under the current pumping condition was used to determine the current status. Drawdown values from current pumping to 2045 was then used to determine future status. So this map shows the location of the 45 MFL water bodies that were assessed in the North Florida Regional Water Supply Planning Area, which include 5 springs, 15 outstanding Florida springs, 21 lakes, and 4 river reaches. Of these MFLs, the water resource evaluation determined that 22 water bodies are currently achieving their MFLs and were projected to achieve their MFLs at 2045. 3 water bodies are identified as being in prevention, and 20 water bodies are identified as being in recovery. The 4 outstanding Florida springs on the Suwannee River are under emergency rule, and technical work is underway to establish the updated MFL. The two springs identified above as being in prevention are Lafayette Blue and Falmouth Springs. Upon finalization of the final MFL, the status of all 4 OFSs on the Suwannee will be reassessed. The impacts to Lake Cowpen, which is shown as being in prevention, will be addressed by the Black Creek Project. For planning purposes, projects to meet future demands that do not increase the use of traditional groundwater should be developed to address MFL constraints, as well as the constraints of the additional water bodies without adopted MFLs to be discussed on the upcoming slides. The Lower Santa Fe and Itchituckee Springs and River gauges are under reevaluation, which is happening in parallel with this planning process. The timing of this process will be reviewed at the end of this presentation. Any new approved recovery or prevention strategies will be appended to this plan. Regions covered by a recovery strategy are marked in pink, and the planning process will proceed according to the adopted strategy. If the projected future demands indicate a greater need for projects than what was documented in the initial strategy, that additional demand will be incorporated into this planning process. Next, we will look at systems that do not have an established MFL. For water bodies without adopted MFLs, river or spring flows and lake levels were extracted from the NEFSEG model runs or pumps off in the 2045 projection. For flowing systems, the percent change was calculated for simulated groundwater flow from pumps off to 2045. A 10% change in simulated groundwater flow was used as a reference criterion. For lakes, the projected change in aquifer level from the pumps off condition to 2045 was calculated. The change in aquifer level was used to evaluate MFL lakes based on lake-specific criteria. There were 42 flowing systems assessed. Of these, there are 22 systems that exceed the 10% screening criteria in 2045 and 20 with flows that meet the screening criteria in 2045. Additionally, there were two lakes assessed, both of which meet the lake-specific screening criteria, and the lakes shown on this figure are undergoing rulemaking currently. The river gauges on the Suwannee and Lower Santa Fe and the springs shown on the Suwannee River are on the Suwannee River Water Management District's priority list, and technical work to establish these MFLs is underway. I will now turn it over to Lori to discuss the wetlands and chloride concentration.